What's up, guys? So you might not believe it, but
my hood's finally black. It's all in color. It is ready to throw on the car,
which means Sylvie is now officially street legal, ready to go, ready to break in, and ready to drive. It looks good from here, right? It's a good 10-footer. The OB Hall sprayed it. He did an amazing job laying the paint. I screwed it up. We had a little mishap, mainly me. So to get you guys caught up, I'm going to rewind the footage and show you yesterday's clips. 2 days ago, we prepped it. Yesterday, we primed it. And today, we're going to paint it. Hopefully.
So, of course, we left off with some high build primer on it. And now
we have to prep it for the paint, which means we have to now wet sand the thing. We have to get this thing nice and smooth so the paint looks nice and smooth.
So, I just finished the first step of wet sanding it.
Now, basically what I was trying to do is just sand out all the small impurities and all the texture in the paint. Because when you spray the primer, it does get texture to it. It's very like, it's a little bumpy here and there. And of course there is some random imperfections from spraying.
Super, super happy with it. I think B-Hall is gonna be very impressed with me. It's super, super smooth. This thing looks brand new.
Now to finalize it, I just have to re-wet sand it with a higher grit. So I'm gonna paint it out real quick. You guys are probably sick of watching me sand, but it's part of the process. So I'm just gonna skip to that being done. We're back. It's been a while, but
I could not be happier on how this came out. This thing is so smooth now. There's not a single imperfection in this whole paint. As long as we be careful spraying it, the paint's gonna look amazing on top of it, so. What do you think of it?
This thing is awesome.
Don't you love it?
I do love it.
See, the camera puts a smile on everyone's face.
It does. If a car makes you smile, then what else do you need, really? Like, that's why everyone drives around these slammed cars that are just like portions of inches to the ground. And everyone else is like, oh my God, how could you do that? And you see the guy behind the wheel, he's like, this is the most fun I've ever had.
It looks good from here.
Feels good.
Right?
Yeah.
Dude, no imperfections anymore, kind of.
See, remember we learned we should use guide coat? I was gonna ask you if you use guide coat.
I didn't. I forgot.
Like, you see here, you probably aren't gonna see it on the camera. But that's just like a skosh of orange peel.
I'm gonna get this down one day.
It's pretty much there. This is definitely as good as some guys in some body shops.
I think that's supposed to make me feel better.
It's perfect.
In drift standards.
Yes, definitely. In drift standards, this is like high quality. You see the comments, people are like, you know, I think you should build a shitty car to drift because now your car's too nice. No, we don't. If Jimmy crashed it, I'm just gonna repaint it. It doesn't matter.
Wanna make a paint booth?
Sure.
All right, this is phase one.
Phase two.
All right, B-Hall, I think we're getting somewhere.
We're getting somewhere now.
We're official, Drew.
Official like a referee's whistle.
All right, guys, here it is. We got our, what a professional ass painting booth. We didn't even go this crazy when we did the bed. All right, guys, so we got the cups, the reducer, activator, paint, and the B-Hall.
The rock and stuff. Just, yeah, that's the rock. No, it's good. No, it's definitely good to have.
Here it is, big moment.
All right, we got the air mover going. Our booth is falling apart.
So the tarp fell down and kind of threw a lot of Tucker hair and dirt on the hood.
I am now the permanent post for this freaking booth.
Oh, man.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, guys, I didn't do the best job sanding. I didn't do the best job cleaning. I didn't do the best job with the booth. And I forced B-Hall to have a dirty paint job, and I feel
no,
really bad.
It's okay. This happens sometimes and when you're painting in a garage.
And you're rushing.
And you're rushing. Especially when you're rushing. This always happens when you're rushing.
Every time.
Never happens when it's you take time.
Okay, I skunked it. I feel really bad. But it's single stage. B-Hall laid on three thick coats. So once this like fully cures and dries, we're just gonna
sand the crap out of it and get a little buff and shine.
Exactly.
This is good to go.
This is setting us up for another video. How to fix messed up paint.
Yeah. Content creation right here.
Welcome back to the future. Now, as you guys probably saw, had a little mishap. Did a crappy job sanding it. There's a lot of waves in it. Did a crappy job cleaning up. I did a crappy job hanging the booth, and it caused the paint job to look a little iffy, and I feel bad because B-Hall takes a lot of pride in his work. and this one didn't come out too well because of me. There's a lot of dirt in it, there's a lot of Tucker hair in it, and it kind of looks like fiberglass, but you know what? It still looks way nice in my old hood. We're gonna be able to wet sand a lot of the stuff out, so we will make this hood look nice. But for the time being, it's a good 6-footer. So we got a lot of things going on today, but the first thing I wanna do is I wanna get the hood on so I can finalize the S13. Once the hood is on, we can start driving around. I can finally get it broken in, start driving it home tonight, and we could get out of the shop, dude. I've been dying. We need to get out of here. I know you guys are getting sick of this scenery, and I am too.
Let's just throw the hood on. You ready for this one? We're just gonna do this. I can't even snap. There it is. Hood's on. Car officially has a hood, and it's kind of weird to see. We could drive this on the road. She is street legal. She is good. So I'm gonna drive this thing home today, finally. But we gotta talk about that thing.
So a lot of you guys are probably wondering, what the hell is a Suzuki Cappuccino? As you guys might have noticed, this is a Suzuki Cappuccino. It's a pretty interesting car. Where do we even begin? Now, the Suzuki Cappuccino was made between 91 and 97. It was made for the Japanese market and the European market, I believe. This one happens to be a 91. The size of it was meant to bring it into a lower weight class, which allowed it to have lower taxes and lower insurance in Japan. This car definitely has its unique features.
Now, this massive motor is a 0.66 liter or 660 cc 3-cylinder turboed engine, putting out a whopping 63 horsepower off the factory lot.
Now, 28 years later, hopefully we're in the 50s. Now, as you guys could probably tell, it is a pretty small car. We'll get this thing compared to me. Now, this car weighs in at a whopping 1,500 pounds soaking wet. I mean, look at this thing. It's a go-kart. It's barely a car.
This one comes equipped with a aftermarket front bumper and side skirts, and I really like the look of them, but that is not stock. What is stock, though, is the top.
What's cool about this car, it is considered four different styles. It is considered a coupe, a T-top, a Targa top, and a convertible. So let's check it out. As you can tell, guys, it is in coupe mode right now. It is fully enclosed, two-door, notchback. It looks good. Now, we're gonna put this thing in T-top mode.
As you guys can see, just like our beloved 300ZX's, it is a T-top. The corners come off, making the roof look like what?
Yeah, T. So
next, we're gonna be like a Supra and go into Targa top mode. We are officially a Targa top. The whole entire roof comes off. It's looking pretty good. Maybe I'll actually fit in this thing now.
But you know what? There's one more mode to it, and that is convertible mode.
Push this button, lift this up. There it is, full convertible mode. This is the Suzuki Cappuccino in its full glory. As you can see, ours comes with a few extras. Comes with a Nismo shift knob for some odd reason. Comes with a Momar horn barn and steering wheel, and also comes with a Cusco half cage. We had the whole cage, but trust me, I don't even think a five-year-old would fit with the whole cage in, so we took it out. But there it is, guys. There is our Suzuki Cappuccino, a little underpowered Toge go-kart we have here. And you know what? It's gonna be a fun journey with this car.
Now, you guys have probably been wondering, what the hell my tall ass gonna be doing with this little Suzuki Cappuccino? So the import company, HP Logic, that imported this car and my Black Z are actually letting me play with this car for a few months. And then what we're gonna be doing is giving it away to a lucky viewer. Ever since this car was imported to the States, it's put smiles on so many faces. It's been such a good time. We wanna pass that on. So letting me, the guys, and of course, Steffi, my girlfriend, play with this car for a few months. Realistically, it's an excuse for Steffi to have a fun car. We're gonna mod it, we're gonna get it all cleaned up, we're gonna make it look good, we're gonna make it perform well. It's gonna be a fun time. Now, we're not trying to do some like crazy big over the top giveaway. Excuse to play with the car for a few months, and that's about it. So more details on that are gonna come soon, but in the meantime, we're just gonna be playing with the Suzuki Cappuccino, having some fun with it, and doing some mods hopefully you haven't seen yet.
The first mod I want to do to this thing, other than a radio, because this thing needs a radio bad, is I want to take off this roll bar for now. I want to get this thing repowder coated, clean it up, and then not put it in until we definitely get rid of the car. It does look nice, but if we remove this roll bar, we'll get way more seat room, because as you can see, it actually prevents the seat from going all the way back. But if we can get the seat to go all the way back, I might have a chance at kind of fitting in this thing.
We hit the jackpot. The wealthy men now. Look at this.
That's actually really cool. I've never seen any of these.
I don't know what this is. It's definitely not currency, but it's really cool. I like that. Seems actually pretty light.
Oh yeah.
Oh, way farther. See, the bottom's out now. Oh, dude. That's so nice.
More leg room.
So much more leg room. Look at this, dude. Like, my knees don't hit the dash. Hey, before, guys, I was like this. I was wedged in here. This is awesome. I could drive it now. Best mod yet. Now the height thing, we're good.
Steffi just stole the cappuccino. She fits in it way too perfectly. What do you think?
I don't feel like small in it.
You fit it kind of well.
Like I fit it. And it's weird because it doesn't feel weird.
Once?
So stoked on it. My left hand isn't used to it yet.
So we have the dealer plate, but we don't have the paperwork for it. So we can't really take it on the road much for the next, until I get the paperwork. I think I'm getting paperwork tonight, so we should be all set to drive it tomorrow. But today, we're gonna play it safe.
How many gears are in here?
There's five. So tomorrow, Steph's gonna be able to take this onto the road. She can take it to work if she wants to. Yeah.
It's like the shrunken cartoon version of a Viper, doesn't it?
Right?
Yeah. So do you love it or what?
I want it.
Yeah, you
want
to keep it?
I
like this more than the Miata.
I know, I really do.
I didn't want to film it because it's kind of weird, but I think every single dude in these units that have walked outside today and seen this thing has walked over and they love it. It's insane at how many people love this car and just like get such a smile when you see it, right? We're gonna get a lot of smiles at it and it's gonna be a great time and we're gonna make this thing look freaking, what is it?
Cute as fuck.
No, bitchin'.
No, yeah.
You look bitchin', there it is. Well, it's the first wash of the season, so.
Wasn't it the first one of last season too?
Yeah. It's a victory wash. All right, we're gonna drive her home tonight, guys. She deserves to look good on the streets.
Dude, this thing's out here looking like a snack. What'd you think, DrewTube?
It's fire.
Right?
I really like it.
Love it. Now, guys, a lot of you guys are going to kill me about not having a front bumper.
I didn't run front bumper last season for like the whole season. I did order clear vinyl for my fenders.
Now, the front bumper wraps around your front fenders right here, and when it vibrates, it ruins the paint. And I know that sounds really annoying, but it's true. So I ordered clear vinyl that we're going to wrap from here down. So I can put my front bumper on and not worry about it, especially when I bottom out and it just scrapes all of it. We'll be all set. So front bumper is going on, I promise.
It was fun going to the cappuccino today.
It's crazy how much more room I have in this thing since I got rid of the roll cage. And it's so much more enjoyable to drive. Steffi is in love with this thing. I can't wait to start modding this thing, making it even cooler than it is.
It just makes everyone stoked that sees it. Like, you're not sitting in a cappuccino and being sad. So it is officially finally time to drive my S13 home for the first time, which is awesome. Honestly, I was really, really trying to find somewhere to end up tonight, you know, sit and do some more filming and stuff. But it's a Wednesday night. No one's really working on their stuff tonight. Couldn't figure out any way to drive. So I'm just gonna drive around. Got a lot of braking miles to catch up on and go from there. But I did get a camera mount. I stole it from Rennick. It was in the cappuccino. It's a suction cup mount. So I'm gonna put the camera in the car and do some like trial footage and see if we could get some driving clips and figure this out. And maybe we'll stop somewhere cool. I don't know. It's late and there's nothing at all going on. So
wish me luck. I'm freaking out. Always such a nervous wreck with my cars, but it looks good.